earthworm channel right there, see that? The darkened area, that's where, once you develop these channels, the earthworms and the roots keep going down the same place. They keep adding organic matter, so it actually darkens it, right? It comes down here, look how deep this goes.
Spend a little bit of time with Dr. Ray Weil, and you'll notice an insatiably curious man who is also a consummate student, teacher, and scholar of soils. Given that Dr. Weil is someone who literally wrote the book on soils, I wanted to hear what he had to say to farmers. I was blown away by his simple answer, which literally added a new dimension to my operational understanding of soils.
Well, you can see this is a deep soils bit. It's at least 6 feet deep. And so kind of the focus of this pit is depth. Let's face it, we're above ground creatures.
Right.
We're really not very comfortable thinking about, you know, what's going on in the soil. Our senses don't work down there too well, you know. You know, soils are a three-dimensional body in the critical zone, and they go on down into the water table, and it's really, most soils are quite deep. And farmers and even soil scientists pay almost all their attention to just the surface soil. In the old days, the soil that they plowed. I hate to say plowed because I've got a big advocate for no-till, but still that plow layer, that surface layer. And they don't think about what goes on below. So even if they're digging up some roots or pulling up some roots, they're usually getting, you know, from the top 6-10 inches of soil, and that's where their mind is. When we apply lime and fertilizer, we make all the calculations based on that. And so I'm trying to get farmers to start thinking a little bit deeper, because there's a lot that goes on deeper, and there's a big resource that they need to use. One of the big things, you know, we're standing in front of some radish cover crops. This is a daikon type radish that Steve Groff had branded his particular selections as the tillage radish, and he got that name because of the work that I did early with him that showed that this would alleviate soil compaction, so the damage done by driving on the soil with heavy equipment and plowing could be alleviated by this root, which is able to push down through and access this huge, deep, in some sense, a huge tank of water and nutrients, especially water in the summer. So, you know, if this is compacted and the topsoil, which is amended with fertilizer, has all the nutrients up here, but the water holding capacity is going to be mostly down here. That's a matter of volume. And if this is separated by a compacted zone, as most farm soils are, then you're really kind of growing your crops in a flower pot.
Yeah. Okay.
And when summer comes along and that flower pot, the water is used up, the roots need to get down here to pull water up, and they'll start going deeper and deeper to get water. But if there's a barrier, you're going to be limiting your yields and your production.